Hello everyone, and welcome to the dark side finale of Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic here on Ragplays. The fleets are clashing in space. The Dark Lord of the Sith awaits, and Revan is just dying to reclaim his title and make Malak suffer for his many transgressions. So with no more ado, let's finish it, folks.
Well done, Revan. I was certain the defenses of the Starforge would destroy you. But I see there is more of your old self in you than I expected. You are stronger than I thought. Stronger than you ever were during your reign as the Dark Lord. I did not think that was possible.
I was always stronger than you, Malak. That was why I was the master.
Once you were stronger than me, Revan. But as your apprentice, I surpassed you. The master must always be stronger than the apprentice. That was why I betrayed you.
You betrayed me from afar. You were afraid to face me, Malak.
No, I was prepared to face you, Revan. But fate presented me with a better option. I saw my opportunity and seized it. The trap set by the Jedi only hastened my decision. If they had not attacked, I would have challenged you for mastery of the Sith soon enough.
You knew I was stronger than you. You still know it.
I cannot deny your resilience. You survived my first betrayal thanks to Bastila's interference. You escaped the destruction of Taris, and you escaped me on the Leviathan. You even survived my attempt to destroy you with the Starforge itself. Fate and destiny have conspired to keep you alive despite all my efforts. We have been inexorably pushed to this final confrontation, Revan. I see now that this can only be settled when one of us destroys the other. Once again, we shall face each other in single combat, and the victor will decide the fate of the galaxy.
All right, let's do this. Apply a force speed to start with, and then we'll open up with a flurry. I think Revan's angry. Follow it with a power attack. Ow, that hurts. All right, doing good on health. I'm gonna take a med pack, though. Another.
You continue to amaze me, Revan. If only you had been the one to uncover the true power of the Starforge, you might have become truly invincible. But you were a fool. All you saw was an enormous factory. All you ever imagined was an infinite fleet rolling forth to crush the Republic. You are blind, Revan. Blind and stupid.
Is there some point to your incessant prattling?
The Starforge is more than just a space station. In some ways, it is like a living creature. It hungers, and it can feed on the dark side that is within all of us. Look around you, Revan. See the bodies? You should recognize them from the Academy. These are Jedi who fell when I attacked Dantooine. For all intents and purposes, dead. Except for one difference. I have not let them become one with the Force. Instead, I have brought them here. The Starforge corrupts what remains of their power and transfers the dark taint to me. You cannot beat me, Revan. Not here on the Starforge. Not when I can draw upon the power of all these Jedi. And once you are beaten, I will do the same to you. You will be trapped in a terrible existence between life and death. your power feeding me as I conquer the galaxy.
I sense great fear in you, Malak. Yeah, so I'm not going to be using any powers against him. He'll pretty much resist everything I throw at him. Take a couple of health packs here. And I'm also going to be fighting him. I could go around and run to each one of these and actually kill them one by one with Force Kill or Wave or Lightning or whatever it happens to be if I wanted to. But I actually want to have this fight play out. I want this to be a proper boss fight. So we'll let him do his thing. I think we can take him. Also, Revan would not want anyone saying that he took the easy way out. Not that anyone would know, but it might come up at some point. Reapply speed and head up here. Fight him. Will he be coming this way? Yes. That's leap over there. Nice, good hit. Good hit. Flurry. Command. Good. And power attack, I think. It's fine. Okay, we got him. Another health pack. I'm gonna keep using these as often as I can. Keep myself near to full health. Reapply speed as well. Back to full. Let's run over there and meet him. Oh, he stripped us of our power. Alright, let's get that back on right now. A power attack, and then a flurry. Alright, we're very low at this point, so what I think I'm going to do, open up the inventory here and do it manually. Use up some of our giant cache of med packs. If he can do it, why not us? 6. That'll do. 12 med packs. Get us back to full. I'll just gain some distance on him. Oh, maybe not. Alright. Let's run out a little bit. Don't let him strip us. I want to jump to him. There we go. Beautiful. And I think I'm going to just basic attack. Okay, we're going to reapply. Let's cancel that. Reapply for speed. And then basic attack. Nice. Okay. And get away with just taking a few of these. Follow him. Reapply force speed. I think we have around 4 of these left, maybe. Maybe a few more. Run up here. Get some height on him. Come on, Malak. Come at me. Beautiful. And a flurry. Ooh, nice. No damage. Takes another one. I could actually go around and leech off of these as well if I wanted to, but kind of don't want to. Get over there. Catch him off guard. Ooh, our speed wore off. Want to get that back up immediately. Do a flurry. And a power attack. Ow, that really hurt. Yeah, we're gonna be healing up after that again. That was some bad, bad luck on that hit. I think he got a crit in. Nearly killed us. 52 health, wow. Currently in combat. What? No, I'm not. That can't be it, can it? What, we got them all? We got them? No, we didn't. Exactly. The heck game. Knew that wasn't it. Can't use it, why not? Alright, can I not heal myself, please? Need to heal. Can't, why not? Okay. Use force heal, might have to stall a bit. Heal a bit more, please. That's his last one. Maybe it's just preventing us from doing that? I don't know. Alright, look. Can I... please... use these. Thank you. That back up to full. That's more comfortable. And... oh, there's one left. Okay. After this. Horse speed. Back on. Let's get the heck over here. Where is he? Up there. Alright, Malik, what are you gonna do? Okay, stripped us right away. Naturally. Reapply, and he's doing a power attack. Ouch. I don't even think that hurt us. Flurry. Good. Health back. Health back. Okay, not quite. We'll run away and take another one. Oh, he's kind of close though, isn't he? We might be able to get away. Yep. Alright. Heal, and another one. Oh, no. Disengage. Force speed's gotta be back on immediately. Okay. And now we fight. Maybe basic attacks only. It's over, Malik. I have the high ground.
Impossible. I cannot be beaten. I am the Dark Lord of the Sith.
No, Malik. There is only one Dark Lord of the Sith, and you are on your knees before him.
Yes. I cannot deny it any longer. You are the one who deserves... who deserves to be the Dark Lord. You were the one who found the first star map on Dantooine. It was you who led us on our quest for the Starforge. I only followed in your wake. I tried to usurp your rule, to steal the title of Sith Master from you. But now I understand. The destiny is yours, Revan. Not mine. You are Darth Revan, Lord. Lord of the Sith. And I am nothing.
At last the apprentice learns his final lesson.
And so it ends, as I somehow always knew it must. In darkness.
Lost another capital ship. It's hopeless. All Republic forces, pull back! Pull back!
It is too late to retreat, Admiral. The Sith Armada has cut us off. There is no escape for us now.
Then the Republic is doomed.
Malak is dead. All hail the return of Darth Revan, the true Lord of the Sith.
All hail Lord Revan. All hail Lord Revan. All hail Lord Revan.
The Sith bow before you. You have reclaimed your rightful throne. The Jedi Order is in tatters. It is only a matter of time until your Sith minions wipe them from the face of the galaxy. The Republic fleet is decimated. The core worlds are defenseless against us.
Well, guys, that was the dark side ending of Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic, and it was pretty damn cool. Although, to be honest, I always found Bastila's coronation speech ends a little too abruptly for my tastes. Almost kind of feels like she was running out of things to say at the end there. But I don't know. Maybe it's just me. I've always been more partial to the good ending, though. There's just something about it that hits you right in the feels. I don't know how to describe it exactly. It just feels right, you know? The dark side definitely has it beat for the confrontation on the Temple Summit, but I find after that, the dark side story never really reaches the same heights again. But anyway, I digress. It was fun. It was fun. Though I guess the story is in need of a brief epilogue now that it's over. So with Malak dead and their enemies fleeing before them, Darth Revan and Bastila seize control of the Sith Armada and begin preparations for their final assault on the dying Republic. Master and apprentice, Emperor and Empress, at long last, nothing can stand in the way of them ruling the galaxy together and founding a dynasty that will last 1,000 generations. So they hope, anyway. Until KOTOR 2 shakes things up. So that's about it, guys. I said a whole lot more about the game and future plans for the channel in the light side finale, so I think I'll just put a link to that video down in the description or in the comments section, rather than retreading the same water here. Like I've said many times over, KOTOR is an amazing game, one of my favorites of all time, and I had an absolute blast playing it over the past 5 years. I really hope you guys enjoyed it too. So, until next time, all the best, take care everyone, and may the Force serve you well. See you, folks.